stepping into the world of intellectual freedom and unscripted ideation. You're listening to the Unstructured Pod with the Wizards of Wonder, Jawan Farah
and Ethan Zaretsky. Get ready to break free from the confines of conventional thinking.
Episode 6 of Season 2, the Unstructured Podcast. Guns out. Hangry season is upon us right now. One of us is extremely hungry, but that's okay.
Yeah, guess which one it is.
Guess which one. Definitely not me with my energy. It's this one right here. Shout out Rangers playing tonight on whatever channel. Ethan Zaretsky. I haven't seen you in a full week and some change. How the hell you been?
I've been good. I've been hangry, but I've been good. I've been living life. This time on Tuesdays and Thursdays, after my first morning classes, I just don't get a chance to eat until either after the podcast or after my live show on Thursday. So this is kind of like an area where I just don't get to eat, and I express my hangriness to everybody. So
yes, which is okay.
Embrace it, because no one will be able to see me when I'm hangry in a week from now. So
sheesh. Yep. Graduation is upon us. They have graduation events going on all next week, I believe, or maybe it's this week, at the Hints Alumni Center. So go check that out. Yeah, like I said off air, I already bawled my eyes out, but I don't say that as in like, oh, feel bad for me, I'm graduating, big boy. I say that as it's a new opportunity. It's just I appreciate the moments and the man that this school has molded me into. Mm-hmm. And the relationships, again, is the biggest value prop for anybody that has not entered college or is beginning their college journey. And it's like, oh, my God, my freshman year passed. Wait till you have a tassel on your head and you're literally taking photos outside of Ole Miss. Because guess what? That's going to become sooner than the Flyers win a Stanley Cup.
Probably. The Flyers definitely won't win a Stanley Cup within the next 4 years. But, yeah, graduation is really sad, and it definitely has not set in, at least for me.
At all?
I guess a little bit. When I was out with my friends on Saturday night, we were kind of reminiscing on all the good times we've had, you know, spending time with each other outside. And, yeah, it was really sad. But, you know, we're not here to live in the past and, you know, reminisce on moments that we enjoyed. We're here to live out the moments that we have in the future. So enjoy all the moments that you have, appreciate them, but move on and build some more memories for yourself in the future.
Thoughts on the bar? How was the bar crawl?
It's good. It was good. Like I said, it was just, you know, it was emotional, but it was good to see everybody. It was good to hang out and
how was the weather?
Enjoy a good time. The weather was good. It was very nice. The sun was out.
Jeez,
the Rangers,
that's a good.
The Rangers won. No, the Rangers didn't play on Saturday. But
the Islanders played on Saturday next.
And they lost next. And they gave up a 3-goal lead yesterday. Next.
Not a big deal.
No, it's a very big deal to me.
Why? You don't even want the Islanders to win.
You don't understand how hard and how excited I was that the Islanders blew that lead.
That's what I mean. You're excited.
Yeah, I was ecstatic. But it all sucked because all my roommates are Sixers fans, and they just choked that game.
By the way, full disclosure, on air, the refs literally sold that game. It should be 1-1.
That's fine. Everyone's got their own opinion. But
and some are objective and some are subjective.
Well, the reality is that it's 2-0 in both of those series. And, you know, the series don't even start until the Islanders lose at home or the Sixers lose at home. So we'll see. When this episode's out, we'll know if the series is 2-1 or 3-0.
I think I have a good pump right now. I can't lie.
That's great. I'm going to be interested to see how, you know, this is the sleeveless pod today compares to the one we did in season one.
Because I have been in the gym, actually, very active. I'm very proud of that.
That's great.
I've been very consistent over the last 5-6 weeks. Shout out Alex Royston. We've been going to the gym together. Guy's absolutely jacked.
That's a W. I think a big part about the gym is having someone that you can go with. And,
yes.
You know, and
I can't go by myself because guess what I do? I then cut myself loose. But when you go with somebody that's going to actually call you out, I'm like, no, 3 more reps.
Yeah.
And then, like, to the point where you're, like, going down and you're not even doing the press. That's how tired you are. That's when you know the gains are coming.
All right, boy.
Sorry, I got to stop.
Yeah, you got to chill.
I got to chill.
Sleeves down. Just roll them down.
I'm hot, bro. It's hot in here.
So take your shirt off. If it's that hot, then just take your shirt off.
Should we take the shirt off? Let me know in the comments.
Well, it's gonna be too late after that. I know I said don't reminisce too much, but what was your favorite moment in college?
Starting on Structure Podcast.
Wow. Okay.
It's definitely top three.
Okay. Well, what's the best? Kid, do you not have?
Dude,
the best?
There's so many. I mean, I don't even begin to tell you. Genuinely, so many. When you're talking here specifically on campus, I mean, You're going to have to say one of the football games for sure. I mean, Rec Hall, Illinois, it's hard to look back in 4 years and, like, some of the things I don't even remember that happened that were crazy, to be honest. Like, that's how. But this year, let's just say senior year, top three. And I'm not going to make them all sports, I promise. Top three. One's got to be Rec Hall, Illinois versus Penn State basketball. That comeback was literally the craziest basketball game I've been in person. Not even a question. Number one. Number two, I would probably have to say I'm going to go Penn State Sports Business Conference. It's just something I've really take a lot of pride in and something I was debating even doing this year, but that one. Third, I'm going to say Travis Scott concert.
Wow. Okay.
Really enjoyed that.
I honestly think when this episode drops, the concert will be tomorrow. I think Luke Combs is going to be in my top five.
Luke Combs is coming?
Saturday, yeah.
Bryce Jordan?
No, Beaver.
Beaver Stadium.
Yeah, Luke Combs.
They're doing a concert in the stadium. How the hell is that going to work?
We'll see.
Like a full-on concert. Yeah. That's the first time ever. It has to be.
No, it's not the first time ever.
But when is the last time you know that they've done a concert in Beaver Stadium?
I don't remember, but we can look it up.
Did he sell it out?
Oh, it's gonna. I mean, it's gonna be rocking regardless. I have a baseball call before, and then after, I'm just going to tailgate. Like,
are you going to the concert?
Yeah, there's no. I'm not missing that. And I was so blessed that the Rangers didn't end up getting a game scheduled that day. Cause
what would you? Okay.
Last year's playoff format, it would have been the game would have been on that day.
And thoughts on that?
And I probably would have went to the Ranger game.
I have a question. If graduation was at the same time as Game 7, what are you doing?
Bro, I'm going to Game 7.
Yes,
I'm not going to graduation. I'm going to Game 7. Or I'm at least, well, actually.
No, ready? So it's
well,
4
I'll go to graduation. 4 o'clock, I'll go to graduation, and then I'll drive to the game.
4 o'clock game, graduation at 12, graduation ends at 2. So you have to make that decision. And you're.
I'm going to the game, and I'm going late. I'm pulling up late to the game, if that's a possibility. Yeah, so I think Luke Combs is going to be my top five.
What's his, like, famous songs? Because I know who he is, obviously. I'm not a bot, but I don't know.
Oh, no, that's Morgan Wallen. I don't know, Hurricane, Long Neck, Ice Cold Beer Never Broke My Heart. Never Broke My Heart.
Is he on the chubbier side?
That's him.
I didn't mean to say that.
I mean, that's just how you describe him.
Luke Combs. Okay, is he top five country artist, like, generally speaking?
Yeah, he's got to be. My cousin Jake saw him at MSG, and I'm really jealous.
Sheesh. And how are the tickets for Beaver? Must have been fat.
No, $50 entry.
No. For Beaver?
Yeah.
But Drake's charging $270.
Well, it was at BJC, less seats.
Okay, and Travis was $50.
Yeah, Travis is nowhere near Drake. They're not even comparable. Yeah, I'm not even going to say it again, but Luke Combs is going to be goated.
Shout out Luke Combs.
When you're seeing this tomorrow, it's going to be insane. Also, tune into my Penn State softball call. It's going to be my last broadcast ever as a Penn State student.
So tune into that.
They're playing Michigan. It's the opening game of the series, Saturday, tomorrow, 1 o'clock. Tune in on Comm Radio.
Let's go. Last one. How do you feel about that?
It'll be exciting. I'm with one of my best friends in the whole world, Matt Cabram. We talk a lot of sports every single day. And, yeah, I think we have a lot of good chemistry.
Is this your first time with softball?
Yeah, first ever softball call.
And have you talked to Michaela at all or any of the girls?
Michaela.
Burbanti.
No, I don't know her.
She came to Reach a couple times.
Oh, okay. That's interesting.
To like get educated. You know how you do with Jarrell? You got to educate it?
Yes, exactly.
So I'm saying, are you going to probably do that with the girls?
Think I'm way too busy this week. Since I don't have any finals as a comm student, all of my stuff is due this week.
Really?
I have to film a story, two stories. And yeah, I think that's it. I think I just need to complete my stories and then I'm done.
Done.
We'll do a writing assignment.
I got two exams next week, two exams this week, so that's four exams in a week, two projects done. Yeah, dude, we got to get the brand deals for where I was at this past week, Dallas, Texas. Shout out Annie Beard, LSU Women's Gymnastics National Championship. Unreal, but we can't forget Jordan Bowers as well, Oklahoma. You know, a lot of people were expecting OU and LSU to be the top two. OU, unfortunately, did not make it, you know. They had a rather surprising, to say the least, performance. But everybody's human. Like, let me just give some context super fast. 3 years, were undefeated. They've won back-to-back Natty Champs, 6 out of the last 9. The last 12 years, they've made it to the national championship. That's like a dynasty in, just a great example of dynasty. So it is by nature to lose as a human. It's just on the biggest stage that they ended up losing, and it didn't happen earlier in the year. They beat every team that won LSU. the top four teams, they literally beat all of them in the regular season. They already compete against them. So they just didn't, when it can't push come to shove, they just didn't take care of business. But Jordan's had an unbelievable year. Got to give OU and them credit. Audrey Davis, Reagan Smith, all the girls. And then, like I said, Annie Beard and LSU, man. First one in program history. It was electric. Wow. First one in program history was electric. ESPN there, ABC, Allie Raisman. Buzz everywhere. LSU travels, bro. And by the way,
I bet.
Trivia question on the pod. How do they spell go in LSU?
G-E-A-U-X.
Oh, my, literally knew
Come
the answer.
Come on, I know that. Because yeah, literally, just hit how do they spell
I
Burrow?
Just hit my chin when I try to do
You've
X.
hit like three body parts today.
I didn't mean to.
How did Joe Burrow spell Burrow? When
B-U-R-R-E-A-U-X next.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, but it's crazy that Go Tigers got the dove, and it was in
Emphatic
fashion.
Emphatic
fashion. Like, can I explain to you? Going into rotation four, you know gymnastics.
Yeah.
They're down 0.5, which is not a lot, but it's still a substantial amount. Like, you have to fall to. I go to Sebastian, who's where they're. Shout out, Sebastian. LSU's losing. Utah is on vault. They're on beam for LSU. Utah has to pretty. If they stick every one, they're winning. Like, it's a hands-down lock.
Yeah.
First girl literally falls flat on her butt.
Oh, my.
Flat on her butt for Utah. But then guess what? I go, oh, we're locked. LSU girl falls. I go, you got to be kidding me. Two girls fall. I'm like, bro, this is the jokes. So now it's actually back to even. And then another girl almost fell, like, on the platform when you, like, land off the mat. She almost fell off the mat, so it was a huge point deduction. And then the last girl for LSU literally by, like, a nail biter, like, stuck it. If she literally, like, cause she wobbled a little bit, if she would have stepped, would have lost. So in emphatic fashion.
So it came down to the last.
Pretty much.
That's crazy.
Actually, like, people were sweating. I couldn't ask Sebastian. I literally was like this. I couldn't watch.
You were locked in?
Yeah, I wanted them to win so bad because LSU has been in the national championship the last 7 years in a row, and they've never gotten it done.
Like the final two teams?
They've been the final two. No, they've been the final four because that's what they do. In the national championship, it's four teams.
Okay, so it's a quad meet.
Yeah, quad meet. And they've literally, the last 2 years, they've been second both times.
Wow.
So they finally got it done.
When did the men's compete?
This weekend.
Wow.
And
Penn State's not in it, though, right?
No, they did not. Well, they were in it, and needless to say, they did not perform. And it's a shame because I know individuals on that team, and it definitely hurts, but it is what it is.
Well, what else do you want to say before we?
Do you have anything else to say?
I don't know. Enjoy life, I guess.
Enjoy life, man.
Life short. And when I'm checking this out in however many years, and if my kids are watching this video, I love you. And yeah, I hope you're doing well.
Last in person podcast. Unless next week.
Yeah, next week we can rip a pod.
So next
week, because so second to last in-person pod.
Second to last in-person pod, at least specifically in the Willard Building.
Yeah.
So definitely appreciate the hospitality that they've had. This is where we start a pod. We literally just literally clipped that. Next. it's been unreal, actually. We've been through multiple studios. We've started over on the other side. That mic never fixed after episode 3, which was our sign to come to the middle one. We did a couple there. Not a fit. We've done it here, and this has been our studio. We appreciate Steve and all the people that work with us for the studio. And I'll end it on sticking the tongue out, which the tongue is the word of the day.
The tongue is the word of the day?
Because you're going to grab at anything in life, and you're going to take it head on.
Okay. That works, I guess. From Ethan Zaretsky and Jawan Farah, thanks for listening to episode 6 of season 2 of the Unstructured Pod. We'll see you next week.